motivational speaker. I'm a business coach and author of the book Ending Status Quo. I have just quickly finished a fantastic workshop on PCI DSS. It stands for Payment Card Industry Data Security Standard. Now, if I picked up the newspaper, and if you see today, they're like, you know, cyber crimes happening every day. Every day there are a lot of issues in terms of card data getting lost, and you know, a lot of phishing and malware happening. So what's happening is people are very scared of actually using your debit card and credit card online. So that's the reason why I thought I'll have this workshop, and this is done by SISA, and it's my pleasure to have somebody with me. I'm going to introduce him. He's a PCI QSA, and he's been a jet setter. He's actually a tour across the world and doing a lot of session in terms of compliance. He also does a lot of audits from different companies internationally. So and he's done a fantastic job for the last 2 days handling all the questions, the different questions coming from the different set of people. It's been a fabulous workshop. I would seriously recommend it. But before that, let's hear from him in terms of why PCI DSS and what's the use of it. So over to you, Kaushik.
Okay. Thank you so much for the lovely introduction. Okay, I don't think that I really need that much, but again, thank you. So with respect to the latest security trends, whatever is happening in the market, I'll seriously say that yes, India is getting impacted hugely because of that India is a big center for the big data. If you look at all the phishing attacks and all those things, right? Okay, it's really because India is using so much technology with respect to the information systems, with respect to the information assets. Okay, that is why these phishing scams and all those things are happening in India. Okay, the ransomware, right? The ransomware, the very new threat that has been created all across the globe, right? Seriously, I think so that only 2 weeks or 3 weeks back we had the new malware, okay, coming into the market, the new ransomware coming into the market. And that is where the PCI comes into picture. Okay, the PCI is a standard that is one of the most mature standard that is available in the market with respect to the payment card industry. Mm-hmm. All right, and if you see like all across the globe, that is the only available standard with respect to the card data security as well. So if you look at the requirements of PCI DSS, okay, they follow a very streamlined approach for protection of your card data. Right. Okay. So if I'm looking at the ransomware itself, okay. So the ransomware, I have enough controls in my PCI DSS standard itself, starting from the firewall to your application security, to your application penetration testing sites, to your web application firewall. Okay. Each and every subtle requirement of PCI DSS, using which you can always and always, okay, secure your environment with respect to ransomware or this phishing attack or whatever is needed. So all these requirements of PCI DSS, right? So if you combine all of them, then you'll be getting a secure card data environment across that, and you are also getting a secure PCI DSS infrastructure as well. Okay. In many of the organizations, whatever we have assessed all across the globe, we have found that even though they are not in, they are not in really need of PCI, okay, but then also they are applying the PCI DSS controls because it's so much mature. This particular sense so much mature as compared to the market, whatever sense of the market, okay. In that people or say organizations are going ahead with it, okay. That's not an issue at all. So even if you are not PCI in nature, let's say if you are not dealing with payment card as well, I seriously suggest that you should have PCI as a, let's say, a normal baseline across your organization.
So what I understand is all the companies like the KPOs, BPOs, the companies which are doing a lot of development nowadays, correct, even the common man, they should actually understand more about the PCI DSS. How's India gearing up right now? Where, because you've been traveling across the world, right, and you're meeting, right, a lot of other corporates and all.
Right.
So where do we think India stands at this point of time? You did answer part of it earlier, but do you want to elaborate more about
absolutely,
how we are compared to others?
Yeah. So let's take the payment security only, okay? Because as like CISA, we are the payment security specialist. Okay. So overall, if we take the payment industry entirely, so RBI is doing a really fantastic job in implementing PCI all across the payment ecosystem in India itself. Okay. So likewise, I'll just give you an example with respect to, let's say, an e-commerce transaction. Okay. In e-commerce transaction in India, it's a mandate that, okay, you should use two-factor authentication for all the e-commerce transaction, whatever you are doing over the web. okay, which is not prevalent in all across the globe. Okay? Similarly, if we talk about, let's say, a card present transaction, okay, because of card present transaction, the PIN is mandatory in India. However, if you just move from India and if you go to, let's say, Singapore, Malaysia, okay, even in the US region, okay, you don't need a PIN, you don't need anything, you just need a signature for a particular transaction to be done. Okay. Apart from that, we have also come up with so many scenarios where even the company or the organization who have went to RBI to get a license for transactions, they are not even dealing with the card numbers. But RBI mentioned that, okay, no, you have to go with PCI at the very minimum baseline, so that the organization is always secure. And then only you can come back to us and say that, yes, we can go ahead with this particular organization, let's say with this particular business, okay, otherwise not. Okay, so yes, I'll say that India is replying back, or let's say is taking much more posture, or let's say security posture, with respect to the latest trends of information security, whatever are coming into market.
Finally, on the PCI DSS training, this workshop, so you have those controls available on the net, you know, what do you think this workshop is so important for everyone to learn who is there in this industry, what's special? I did learn a lot, but you want to add something onto whatever?
Absolutely. So actually, if you look at any of the standards, okay, whatever available in the market, okay, it entirely depends upon the consultant, whosoever is implementing that into your organization. All right, because it's completely based upon that particular USA or let's say particular SSS knowledge base. Okay, and that depends upon that how many organizations has he audited in the past, and accordingly he will be imparting the knowledge on your organization as well. All right, so if you look even in the standard, the PCI is a standard for such an example. Okay, in that as well. Okay, many of the requirements are so much, you can say, generic in nature. All right, so that you have to go back to the USA and ask that, okay, what does a strong cryptography mean? Okay, how to define a crypto period with respect to same? What are the things to consider an open public network? If I'm having a shared MPLS cloud, okay, is it an open public network or a closed public network? Okay, or let's say in the case of a wireless ATM, okay, how will you be able to construct a wireless ATM network? Okay, if it's coming over 3G network, for example, okay. In that case, our answer will be that, okay, you have to use a unique API and a unique access point name with respect to same. Okay? Similarly, when the case of an HSM comes, a hardware security module comes, then where exactly will HSM fit in PCI DSS domain? Right? Because if you start from requirement 1 to 3 and all, they'll just say that, okay, it's for the storage of the keys. Apart from the storage of the keys, it's also being used to distribute the keys. Right, so that's where a QSA knowledge comes into picture, and that's where CISA and the CPSI course comes into picture.
Okay,
to get you a detailed understanding with respect to the entire standard, okay, that it helps you in the implementation of each and every requirement, okay, and to understand basically the applicability of the PCI DSS standard inside your organization. Okay, that's really, really important.
Thanks, thanks very much. It was really lovely to understand so much.
Sure.
So, thanks very much. All the best.
Thanks.